is Sarah with Posh Pooch Designs, and today's video, you're just going to love this. This is a wonderfully easy cowl, and it's completely versatile. You can make it as long as you want, as thick as you want, and you can make it with any kind of yarn using any kind of hook. So how can we do this, you ask? It's really simple. The pattern is basically chains attached with single crochets. And you can use any kind of yarn, because as long as you choose the hook that the yarn recommends, it will work out just fine. Now, these are three that I made using three different Red Heart yarns. This is the Red Heart Americana. It makes a really nice lightweight cowl, and I made this one longer. And instead of adding buttons, I added some beads, and that's something fun that you can do. We toss that one over there. This one, I believe, is Red Heart Unforgettable, but I might be wrong on the name of it. It is a Red Heart yarn. It's one that I made one of my messy bun hats out of, that I wear back and forth to the gym. So I used one of the skeins and just made a long cowl. You can see it's made exactly the same, chains and single crochets, really simple. I didn't even put an edge on this one. So it's a really, really easy pattern, and you can make it look all different kinds of ways depending on what kind of yarn that you choose. For today's demonstration, I'm using this yarn. It's Red Heart Soft Essential Stripes, and this is the Purple Rain variegated. And I just love this yarn. And I'm using one of my own polymer clay buttons for the tie. And we're going to be using a K-hook today. This is 6.5 millimeter. You're also going to need a nice big needle for sewing on your button and weaving in your ends, and a pair of scissors for clipping those yarns. Now, like I said, you don't have to use this yarn. And the way the pattern works is it's repeats of 7 chains. And that's how you make it longer. And then you can make it as deep as you want by adding as many rows as you want. If you make this pattern, which is a new free pattern on my blog called Soft Chains Cowl, if you make it according to the size, you're going to get a cowl that's about 24 inches around, and it's going to be about 9 inches deep. Now, of course, that depends on how you crochet. So this only takes one skein of this Soft Essential Stripes, so it doesn't take very much. This is also a great pattern if you want to practice, because it's a neat, easy, I'm not calling it a beginner, because we are going to start with a single foundation single crochet. I'm going to have two options, but I'm calling it an easy pattern. So just grab you some of your favorite yarns, whether it's a solid, a thick, thin, fuzzy, chunky, they all work, and that hook that goes with it. And if you're using the Soft Essentials, of course, we're using the K hook like I stated, and we'll get started. You're going to love this cowl. It is so simple and so versatile. Now, there are two ways that we can begin. The first thing you need to do is to decide how many repeats you want to make. 7 chains is approximately 2 inches, and that's around, because we're stitching around. And I'm going to make 5 repeats of 7. There are two ways that we can begin. The first way is to chain those 5 sets of 7 chains. And I'm going to show you how to do a foundation single crochet. And I like to start this cowl with that because it makes a nice stretchy cowl and makes it a lot more comfortable to wear. So we're going to start with our slip stitch. Put our hook in and chain 2. 1, 2. So now we have 2 loops, or 2 chains, and we're going to go in that second chain and pull up a loop. We're going to yarn over and only go through the first loop. That gave us our chain. Now we're going to yarn over and go through both loops, and that gave us a single crochet. When you do a foundation single crochet, you're doing your chain and your single crochet at the same time. All right, so now we're going to go back through that first chain that we made, pull up a loop, yarn over and go through the first loop, yarn over and go through the two loops. And you can see these are much easier to count as you're going. So we're going to go in this loop, pull up a loop, yarn over and go through the first loop, yarn over and go through the two loops. And we're going to do this for 5 sets of 7. I'm just making a little miniature demonstration, and hopefully this will fit on Rosie's neck and you can see how it looks on my pooch. And see how that looks? We go in the loop, pull up a loop, yarn over, go through one loop, yarn over and go through two loops. That's your foundation single crochet. And you need to do 7 times as many as you want your cowl to be. And like I said, I'm doing 7 times 5. Now, if you're doing option 2, you're just going to do the same thing, slip knot, and then you're going to chain 7 times 5, or however many, 7 times however many that you want to make. And then without twisting, you'll join after you have the length that you want. There we go. And then you'll place 1 single crochet in each single crochet around. And then you'll join to the first single crochet, just like we're going to do with the foundation single crochet. So that gives you 2 options that you can use to do the beginning row. You either need 7 times 5 is what I'm doing, or 7 times what, however many that, how long you want it. If you want your cowl to be the length of the one that I made, you're going to need to do 84 chains join and then 84 single crochets, or 84 foundation single crochets and join. I have made 5 repeats of 7 foundation single crochets. If you chose to chain and then place 1 single crochet in each single crochet around, we're going to join whether you did the foundation single crochet or the regular. We're going to join, and this is the only time that we'll be doing joining on this project. And we'll just join to that first single crochet with a slip stitch. And you'll notice if you did the foundation single crochet that you've got a little bit of a gap here. Don't worry about that right now. We're going to use this extra piece of yarn to close that gap. But this is only if you did the foundation single crochet. All right, now for row 2, it's exactly the same whether you did the foundation or whether you chained and put 1 single crochet in each chain around. What you're going to do is you're going to place a single crochet in the same stitch where you slip stitch. So we're going to stitch a single crochet, and then we're going to chain 6. So we stitched a single crochet in the first stitch, and now we chained 6, and the next thing we need to do is we need to skip 6. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we're going to place a single crochet in the next stitch. One single crochet, we skipped 6 stitches, and then we single crocheted after chaining 6 in the 7th stitch. And that's the way the first row will go. We single crocheted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're going to chain 6, and now we're going to skip 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're going to place a single crochet in this 7th single crochet. And then we'll chain 6 again. 1, 2, 3, four, five, six. And we'll do this all the way around. Single crochet, chain six, skip six, single crochet in the next stitch. Chain six, skip six, single crochet in the next stitch. One, two, three, four, five, six, and then single crochet in the next stitch. And you'll do that all the way around for row two of your cowl, because we're setting up the foundation of how the rest of the cowl is going to go. I have finished going around. I have done my single crochet, chain six, skip six, then single crochet all the way around, because I have one, two, three, four, and this is my fifth repeat, because I'm doing five repeats of the seven chains. And what you're going to do on the last one, you're going to skip those six stitches, but you're going to place a single crochet in that first single crochet. And this is really important for the look of the cowl. You're going to need, don't go through the top two loops. That's how we normally crochet. But what I want you to do is, if you look at the stitch, there's those two bars going up, and you're going to go right inside those two bars and stitch your single crochet. And I'm going to grab this other one so you can take a look at what I'm talking about. It gives you this almost a knit look on top. Instead of stitching in the top, we're going in between those two bars each time we stitch our single crochet. All right, so let's go ahead and chain six. One, two, three, four, five, six. And now we're going to move over to our next single crochet. And again, you can see those two bars. We're going to go right in between those two bars and stitch a single crochet. And then we'll chain six. And this is the way this row works. Single crochet in the single crochet, chain six, and then single crochet in the next single crochet, and chain six, making sure that you place that single crochet in between those two bars of the stitch rather than the top of the stitch, so that you get that look that we're looking for. Chain six, three, four, five, six, and single crochet in the single crochet. And this is the way that your cowl will look. And then you'll go all the way around. One, two, three, four, five, six. Single crochet in the single crochet. One, two, three, four, five, six. There's my six chains. And you'll continue to do that. You won't join. You don't join in chain one. See, here's the beginning of where we started of this row. And yours will look like this too. This is where we need to join this together from our foundation single crochet. But you don't join or chain one or anything. You just go right in that next single crochet, stitch the single crochet, going through those two bars, and then chain six. And you continue to do this all the way around your cowl until it's the length that you want. Now, if you want to do it according to the pattern, you'll need to do this, I believe, 24 rows. Let me look at my notes just to make sure. Yes, you'll do row three. You'll repeat single crochet, chain six, single crochet in the next single crochet, for 24 rows to get the length that this one has. This is the row that we started on, and that's why, and I like the way that this lays, because it gives you just a little bit where it's going to sit on your neck. It gives you a little bit of flare there. And then you're going to stitch 24 rows, chain six, single crochet, chain six, single crochet, for 24 rows exactly the way that I showed you on the little demo. I have stitched as many rows as I need for Rosie's neck. Now, if you're following the pattern, you're going to need to make 24 rows in order for it to be the size of the one in the pattern. 24 rows of the single crochet, chain six, single crochets working down. Is that not just gorgeous? All right. So now we're going to make the trim. I meant to show you that. Here's the trim on the edge of the cowl. Now you don't have to make a trim. The other one I didn't put a trim, but this one needs a trim. And I changed colors. So I'm just going to stick that underneath. The first thing you need to do is go ahead and make that single crochet in that single crochet, like we always do, but we're going to be working through the chain six space. So we're going to go around that chain and stitch five single crochets. So I stitched five single crochets. Then I'm going to stitch one single crochet in that single crochet, and then I'm going to stitch five single crochets in the next chain six space. And then single crochet in the next single crochet. And we'll do this all the way around this row, stitching one single crochet, and then five single crochets in the chain six space, one single crochet in the single crochet, and then five single crochets in the next chain six space. And we'll do this the rest of the way around, and on this row, we're actually going to join. After you've stitched your trim all the way around the edge of your cowl, you're just going to join to that first single crochet and tie off. And now, if you did yours where you chained and then single crocheted at the beginning, you're done and ready to add your button. But if you did the foundation single crochet, you're not done yet. What we have to do, there it is we need to close this little section. So we're just going to take a needle and thread that tail of yarn on there. And we're just going to go across over here. There we go. And just close that little section up with a couple of stitches. Then we'll just go underneath and weave in that end. We just want to make sure it's closed and doesn't come undone. All right, I'll go ahead and clip that off. Alrighty, I need to weave in that purple one too. Alright, so the last thing that you need to do, if you want to, is add a button. And you're going to add a button about halfway down. And when you do, make sure you sew over one of these sections so that it will stay put. And the button is just to hold on the tie that we're going to make. And the tie, basically, you just chain 40, simple tie, and you take it like this, and you go underneath, like this, and you put the tails through. And then, you're going to hook that around that button. And that's just going to hold that in place, so that when you wear it, you have ties. Now, actually, it should go this way because this wider edge is the edge that sits down by your shoulders, and the more narrow edge is the edge that sits up by your neck if you wear your cowl this way. Now, remember, you can use any kind of yarn. You can use the hook that goes with that yarn, and you can make this any length or style that you want. Like I did with these. This is a very versatile pattern, and it's a lot of fun to make, and it's really quick to whip up, and it's a great project if you're a beginner to maybe learn and practice chaining and single crochets. And like I said, you don't have to do the foundation single crochet. You can just start with chaining the number that you need, repeats of 7, and work from there.